Hey guys, MaxLPQueen here, and welcome back to another episode of our Pokemon Emerald Randomizer Nuzlocke Speedrun. In the last episode, we caught just about every Pokemon on every route that we had left over that we needed for our Nuzlocke. And the only two that we are missing is from Evergrande City or Evergrand City, however you say it. I personally used to call it Evergrande, I don't know why. And Victory Road. So those will be our last two Pokemon that we'll be able to catch. Quick team update here though before we get started. We have Mewtwo here who knows Confusion, Iron Tail, Thunder, and Swift. Lunatone, Psywave, Hypnosis, Confusion, and Rock Throw. I got everyone to about the same level, 34, 35, 36. Lapras, Surf, Body Slam, Ice Beam, and Confuse Ray. And then next we have Medicham here who knows Hidden Power, High Jump Kick, Confusion, and Strength. And I believe Hidden Power is Dark, but I'm not too sure. Latios with Secret Power, Luster Purge, Dragon Breath, and Aerial Ice. And then last, our highest level, level 37, our Torkoal, who knows Curse, Flamethrower, Fire Spin, and Body Slam. So in this episode, we are going to be taking on the Mossdeep Gym. And since there isn't too many trainers, we're going to take on the Gym Leaders as well. And we're going to have to deal with some Team Magma things that they got going on and some plans. We're going to have to just destroy those plans later on in the episode. And then we'll end it off after that. But, like I said, in the last episode, we caught all the Pokemon that we will need for the rest of the Nuzlocke. Basically, I have another team if I do run out. Or, not run out, but if something happens, I do have basically a backup team in play. And of course, I don't know if you guys can hear that, but my kittens are going completely crazy right now playing all over the place because they just got their eating, so they're all hyper and they just woke up because I just woke up and had some time to record, so I thought I would go ahead and do that for you guys while I have some time because the episodes haven't been coming out as often as they used to. Because Omega Ruby and Alpha Sapphire has come out, and I really have been playing that and been worrying about that and not really focusing too much on this because the hype is so much and the hype is so great or whatever you want to call it. But basically, we're just going to take on the gym trainers and the gym leaders, and then we should be good with that. We are going to read here on this article about the new after game in Omega Ruby and Alpha Sapphire. For those of you who have already played it, you probably know what this is about. Me personally, I haven't got there yet, so I'm not too worried about it. This doesn't give spoilers, I don't think. It just talks about what the story is going to be about, I believe. And it doesn't give too much away because this article was wrote before the games were released. So it probably won't be as accurate as it is now that the games are released. But it's on Siliconera, siliconera.com. It says, Pokemon Omega Ruby and Alpha Sapphire's new story episode is about the mystery of Mega Evolution. Let's see. On the game's official website, the Pokemon Company has shared a few more details on Episode Delta, a new story segment in Pokemon Omega Ruby and Alpha Sapphire. And there just went my page. You can find an overall summary of the episode in the previous report, blah blah blah, but if you want a few more tidbits of info, we should read on. Episode Delta, according to the game's developers, clears up the mystery behind Mega Evolution. When the Mossdeep Space Center discovers a giant asteroid approaching the planet, the player will need to travel around Hoenn to defend the region against this threat from space. The asteroid is in some way connected to events dating back 3,000 years, which seems to have something to do with the occurrence of Mega Evolution. As the asteroid approaches, Team Aqua or Team Magma, depending on which version of the game you have, begins targeting trainers to steal the special stones required to make Pokemon Mega Evolve. Meanwhile, Steven himself sets out to try and defend Hoenn from the asteroid. Somewhere along the way, you'll piggyback on Mega Rayquaza into outer space. The Pokemon Company says both Deoxys and Rayquaza will appear before the player. All four of Deoxys' forms are confirmed to be in the game. And you can find screenshots of them below, blah blah blah. Following their order, regular, attack, defense, and speed. So, basically, it's just letting us know what we have to look forward to in the aftergame. But this kind of interested me a little bit. That's why I got it, because it said that the asteroid connected to events dating back 3,000 years ago, which, if you'll remember from Pokemon X and Y, AZ, I believe, he's been searching for his missing Pokemon for 3,000 years, and a lot of people speculated that AZ was actually in from like 3,000 years into the future. This is in, and I don't know if I believe that, because In was a very loving person and he always loved Pokemon and he just wanted the best for them and all that stuff and all that jazz. I don't really have nothing against In, but they were saying that AZ was supposedly in from 3,000 years in the future and all that. Whether you believe that or not, it's your opinion. I personally don't believe it, but I do think it's very interesting that it dates back 3,000 years ago, and then we have 3,000 years ago AZ, who was searching. So we gotta get a pattern here and a sense of things. And if you really want to go in depth on it, you could say that it is N who is AZ from in the future, and we could be having a remake of the Unova games. I believe that would be Black and White and Black and White 2. But I don't really see a reason for the remakes, because we have Black and White 2, and that was the remake of Black and White. It was just kind of a sequel. So I didn't really see a need to remake it into the 3D form. We just got Omega Ruby and Alpha Sapphire because they never remade the games, and you know, this is an old game, and they're bringing it back to the 21st century. And you know, we could expect like Pokemon Red, Blue, Yellow remake. Probably not a Pokemon, any Johto remakes we probably won't have though, because we did get Heart Gold and Soul Silver. And then maybe a Sinnoh remake could be coming, maybe later on in the future a Kalos remake. You know, you never know what the Pokemon Company has in store. But also, it says in here that you can ride on Rayquaza into space, and you will be able to encounter Deoxys and all of his forms. A lot of people were saying that, I think I actually talked about this before, but some people were saying that you will end up fighting like May and Steven and Wally and like another rival, I believe, or Brendan or whoever you picked as your person to start with. And each time you defeat one of them, you'll run into Deoxys and one of its forms, and then when you run into its final form, you'll be able to catch it. In my experience playing, oh goodness, it's been a long time since I played that, the Pokemon Ranger games, I don't know if you guys remember those, where they're on the DS and you had to use the bottom screen to circle the Pokemon and capture them. I actually enjoyed those games, but a lot of people didn't like them. I know what, when you had to catch Deoxys, you couldn't catch him when he was in his defense form. You could only catch him when he was like in his regular form or his attack form or his speed form, and not his defense form. Basically, you couldn't catch him in his speed form either because he was too fast. But it might be something like that, maybe. My opinion on the next game, I know we're getting a little bit off topic, but I just want to give my opinion on the next game here that I think could be coming out, just from the little bits and pieces that I'm playing, of Omega Ruby and Alpha Sapphire. Now, I'm pretty sure this probably won't be true, and it's just a speculation from me, but I believe that we are going to get a XD or Colosseum remake for the ones that we played for the GameCube, Pokemon XD Gale of Darkness, I think, and Pokemon Colosseum that were for the GameCube. I believe those will get a remake next. Now, whether that's true, I'm not too sure about that. But who knows, really? Just from playing little parts of the game, you know, I know a lot of you don't want spoilers, so if you don't want to get spoiled by anything in the game, you should probably, I mean, I don't know if you should skip this or not, because it's not really in any information. It's just kind of things that I've found. The megastones that you find in the game, you can find them in-game before the end of the game and before you have your mega bracelet. And they actually appear on the ground as the little sparkly things, you know, like they did in X and Y. I'm kind of thinking that's something kind of like XD and Colosseum did, because they did actually sparkle, you know, when you picked up an item. If you've ever played those games, the items would flash, and it just, the way that the games look now, they look similar to the way that they looked on the GameCube, because everything was all 3D and stuff on the GameCube, kind of, you know. And these games here, we finally got into that 21st century, if you want to call it that, with the 3DS software. Now, whether they'll be on the GameCube, or not the GameCube, because that's way outdated, but whether they'll be on, like, a console or a handheld, like the DS, is yet to be seen. But that's just my opinion. I think that would happen, but I doubt it will happen. That's just something I would want to see, because I personally liked those games and I enjoyed them very much. It was the first time I played a Pokemon game where it felt kind of 3D-like and something like what the future could hold for Pokemon. It was actually pretty cool to get to see stuff like that, so now that we finally do get to see it, it's real nice. But we did defeat the gym leaders a while ago. I was not paying attention, I was in my own world. We did defeat the gym leaders, and now we are defeating Team Magma, because they're at the Space Center trying to probably steal the spaceship or whatever for their diabolical plans to capture Groudon and all that stuff, but we're going to stop them. We're going to have a little help here from our buddy, you'll see in a minute. Basically, that was pretty much all I had to talk about in this episode, because, I have some other things that we can talk about in the next episode, some reviews of the game on different websites, and I would like to give my opinion on them, because some of the reviews I agree with and some of them I don't. I think you have to be a Pokemon gamer extraordinaire to be able to review a game, even though there's people that do it anyway and they're not big fans of the games. But we have plenty to talk about, a couple more articles that I have to read on, and then I should be finding some more soon. We do have, like, a little short one here, I do believe. Nah, that one's long too. I don't really want to get into depth on the articles because they are pretty long, and we are about to end the episode off in a few minutes here. So, we're just going to go ahead and continue on in the game. As you can see right now, we are fighting the last of the three Team Magma members. They're trying to stand in our way, but they only have one Pokemon, so I don't know how they thought they could do that. And here we see Steven, who is being pushed around by Maxie, and ooh, he just punched him in the face there. But he needs our help, unfortunately, so we're going to help him out. And I'm going to send in my bulkiest Pokemon that I have, and the strongest that I have, to take on Steven. He's got a Bayonet, a Ho-Oh, and a Dugtrio, which of course is way different than his originals, but this is a randomizer, so it is different. These guys, unfortunately, are going to lead out with an Aggron and a Fortress, who I can't really touch with Latios. So, super effective Torkoal with his flamethrower is going to work on both of these guys. This Dugtrio is going to use freaking Attract. Really? A Dugtrio with Attract? I didn't really understand it. And he kept using not very effective moves too, which got on my nerves a little bit. And that's why I wasn't really upset when that Dugtrio died, because it wasn't really helping us out very much at all. So we took out the Fortress, and now we have Ho-Oh to deal with, of course. And I decided to go ahead and try to take out the Ho-Oh because I thought it would be pretty hard to defeat. It was going to be pretty bulky and going to get in our way, and I figured Bayonet or somebody could take out the Aggron, which Bayonet did. And unfortunately, this Bayonet does not like Steven very much because its frustrations are doing a whole lot of damage. So basically, there was two fire types out there, and I couldn't really do very much to this Kangaskhan, and I couldn't do anything to the Magmar, so I thought I would switch out into someone else. I knew I already had the curse up, and I did not have any healing items, which I do need to do in the next episode, is buy me some healing items. I'll probably do that off screen. And I decided to go ahead and just try to decide what to do, really. I was just like, I don't know what to do. I can't flamethrower or anything on this Magmar, and the Bayonet is doing good damage to the Kangaskhan, so I thought, you know what, I got the curse up, might as well stay in. And then whenever we get down to the Magmar, switch out, because Torkoal couldn't do anything. As you guys see, that frustration is doing a lot of damage. That frustration, man, that Bayonet does not like Steven at all. And then I made the stupid play of using Luster Purge on a Shiftry, when of course I knew it would not affect it. But of course Bayonet gets a critical hit, so that's good for us, and my mistake was not taken for granted by Team Magma. But we did defeat them, and Steven wants us to, I guess, go to Rustboro City. I don't know, I didn't really read what it said. He has a gift for us. I believe that's in his house, though, but we can go get that in the next episode. I'll find out if we do need to go to Rustboro City, but I doubt that. I believe we have to get an item from Steven, and we should be good. But that's going to do it for this episode, you guys. We will continue on in the next episode, so if you like the video, leave a like, subscribe to watch more of my videos, and comments are always appreciated. You can leave them down below. I will see you guys in the next episode of our Pokemon Emerald Randomizer Nuzlocke Speedrun.